Sara Gideon this election because she cares about Maine's people.
We are here having a roundtable discussion with Sara Gideon, and it was so informative.
I fully support Sara Gideon because I truly believe that she has veterans' issues close to her.
So eat lots of delicious Maine oysters, and please support Sara Gideon for U.S. Senate.
She is for veterans, and I am for Sara Gideon.
I am supporting Sara Gideon.
So privileged to support Sara Gideon.
I think she would be a wonderful senator.
Sara Gideon is going to stand up for people in queer different conditions.
She is going to be our voice.
I am voting for Sara Gideon, and I can't wait to elect her.
I'm so proud to be on Team Gideon.
I'm Team Gideon.
I'm on Team Gideon.
And that's why I am on Team Gideon, and I hope you join me.
Hi, my name is... Good evening. When we launched our campaign last June, I made my decision to run for Senate for the very same reason that I first decided to run for my local town council years ago. I looked at the world around me and saw the change we needed and the ways we could improve the lives of people around us. After months of listening and talking with Mainers from all across the state, I know that's what we need now more than ever. Tonight, we are one step closer to making that change, and I'm proud to be the Democratic nominee for U.S. Senate. I want to thank Betsy Sweet and Bree Kidman for running such passionate campaigns. I know Betsy and Bree got into this race because of their deep belief that Mainers deserve a senator who will stand up for what's right, and I look forward to working with them to serve the people of Maine. And I want to thank the thousands of Mainers who attended a supper with Sara or a virtual town hall, the volunteers from Kittery to Fort Kent who helped us collect petition signatures, make phone calls, and encourage their neighbors to vote. And most importantly, the people of Maine, who continue to share their challenges and their hopes with me. This campaign is about all of us and about how we can build a stronger future together. We are facing unprecedented challenges right now. The coronavirus pandemic continues to threaten our health, our safety, and our economy. And a broken Washington fails to take action because politicians put special interests in partisan politics before the people they're supposed to represent. If we're going to come together and make real progress to improve the lives of people here in Maine and across the country, then we need new leadership. Because after 24 years in Washington, Senator Collins has become part of that broken system, putting special interests and her political party first. And Mainers know it and feel it. At a time when towns and cities, small businesses and workers need more relief from the federal government, we remember her vote for a nearly $2 trillion tax break that went largely to the wealthiest Americans and big corporations, not people like us here in Maine. Over the last few weeks, we've watched the Supreme Court decide cases that could affect millions of Americans, and we remember that Senator Collins has been a key part of Mitch McConnell's effort to stack the federal bench with unqualified far-right judges. And as President Trump continues to divide our country, we remember all of the times when Senator Collins enabled and excused his attacks on our democracy. Senator Collins has changed, and Mainers deserve better. Mainers deserve a senator who will bring people together to overcome the challenges we face and deliver real results. That's what I've always worked to do. On the town council, we didn't have a D or an R next to our names. We just worked together to improve people's lives. And after some of the most contentious years in state government, I've made it clear that I will and can work with anyone to get things done. That's how I brought people together to protect Mainers with pre-existing conditions, to crack down on the price of prescription drugs, to address the opioid crisis and set the most aggressive goals for addressing climate change our state has ever seen. With the way that Washington seems to be so broken, I know it is easy to be discouraged. It's easy to think we can't make progress, but I don't buy that. I've always believed that if you're willing to sit down and listen, especially to those who you think you disagree with the most, it is still possible to get things done. I'm running for Senate today because I know we can take on our toughest issues and work together to ensure that everyone has access to healthcare that is excellent and affordable. to build an economy that truly works for every person, putting the interests of working families and small businesses first, to invest in ourselves, and to finally tackle special interests' influence in our politics and return our government to the people. We've always taught our kids to look around them and to decide how they are going to take part and make a difference. That's why I'm running for the Senate today, because I look at what's happening in people's lives and I see how we can come together and build a better future for everyone. We all have the opportunity to help make that happen this November. If you want to join us, text JOIN to 674-00, and I hope to see you soon. Thank you.